Today we're going from the Palmer House Inn to just a random place in Falmouth, and then back to the public library, and then back to the inn. So let's see how she does. It's raining. It's kind of my thing right now. We gotta wait for these wipers to calm down because, as we know, if it's going too fast, it won't even activate. So let's go to Stop and Shop, I guess. Shaw's, let's go to Shaw's, it's local. It's only a mile. So I'm leaving the destination charger. This parking lot is well out of the realm of FSD, so I'll do it. Yes, I know. Pardon my upper control arms. They get extra squeaky when it's wet. We've got an appointment at the end of the month to get them replaced. All right, so it can't get on the road itself here, typically. Slow wipers. Ah! Full self-driving unavailable because of the freaking wipers. Standby. It's not a very useful drive if it's not driving. There we go, they've calmed down a little bit. I don't mind if it says degraded, but if it's not even gonna try, then there's no point in doing an FSD in the rain video. Might as well be like the one I did from the live stream studio, showing you that it doesn't work. All right, I can't activate from here. I think it's still not activated. Yeah, unavailable. Unavailable. It's not poor weather. You can see clearly. Oh, now it wants to drive. Oh, no, it doesn't? Okay, fine, whatever. There we go. Okay, welcome back. I understand cautiousness, but the wipers being on just a little bit is a lot different from a heavy rainstorm. So that would be my biggest critique of 10.4 and 10.5 together. 10.5 is a lot smoother for us overall. We've mostly only used it in the dark, but it works in the daytime. And still got some weirdness about it. Like the fact that it just tried to slow for some yellow lights for the school zone that weren't even on, let alone that they were flashing. The flashing light performance on 10.4 and 10.5 has been crummy, and I hope to see it it return to greatness at some point, but it ain't now. That wasn't a speed bump, it was like a bad dip in the road. It's really cautious at this particular intersection, but did much better here in the rain than it did anywhere else. I wonder if I need to update this series and call it In the Drizzle, because it's not going to work in the rain. There was a part of town where there was an intersection that wasn't set up very well, and it tried to turn into oncoming traffic. That was fun. All right, don't hit the postman. All right, now you're stopped in the street. Okay. Oh, okay. It was starting to go, but I'm going to give it a little bit of a lightning pedal because we had an oncoming CRV. Yes, my car sounds like an old bed. It tried to go around the postman. That's not good. There you go. You got this. I've got high blood sugar. Where are you going? So, yeah, I don't really often have, disengagement-free drives. I usually have to either nudge it along with lightning pedal, which I don't typically count, or I have to take over for it doing something foolish, like trying to go on the wrong side of the road for no reason. Turn off this bun warmer. We just had breakfast, and so a little out of sorts. Well, let's stop and shop. We're going to Shaw's, which is up here. It's still a chain, but it's a local chain. I'm finding on 10.5, I have to rescue it from being stuck in the middle of the road quite often. That was unacceptable. Yeah, there's your turn. That's where you should have stopped. Because you had the right of way. You didn't need to let those people out. You would have got us rear-ended if there was anybody there. Wait, wait. So it's not a two-lane option. It's a one way. All right, you need to go to the left, not to the right. Good job. All right, you got it. Come on. All right. Door side service, it looks like. So they were out of the sealing gel for these upper control arms when it was time for us to get the recall done, and when they got it back in stock, it already started to squeak. So since we're out of warranty, that became our deal. Good job. All right, so now we will go to the library. You're not supposed to use it in parking lots, so let's see how it does here. Oh, pedestrians. Perfect. So once they replace those upper control arms and give us an alignment, oh, it stops with the stop sign on the little thing. That's cool. Our car will be back to being a fully silent EV. All right, you see the guy? You gonna stop? Good job. You stopped a little far out, but with the speed you're going, that made me more comfortable. All right, more pedestrians. All right, keep going. You got this. No, she's gone. Huh? What, do you need something from Home Goods? Oh. All right, you figured that one out. Oh. All right, stop sign. There it is. It saw it through the bushes. All right, so here I'm gonna probably end up taking over if it tries to creep out into the middle of the road. It looks like it's looking underneath the sign here, so that's pretty cool. we'll see what it actually ends up doing. Alright, if it creeps any further, I'm going to put the brakes until I see it's clear. Go faster than that. If you're gonna jump out in traffic, you need to do it. So I just gave it a little bit of the lightning pedal, just a little bit. I wasn't even accelerating, it was doing all of that. And of course, it keeps clearing my menu. There are no meetings on holiday. All right, let's see how it handles this. I think it's just gonna nose up the end there. Or it might let this person in. We'll see. I mean, obviously that person, but it wasn't letting the VW in, but they know they muscled their way through. Jerk. Just because one person's allowed in doesn't mean that you need to fit two and three cars. That's how it works. Alternate. Especially if they're being polite and letting you in when you don't have the right of way. And so just to be sure, I am still in assertive mode. The other thing I was going to show you guys was our map version hasn't changed. We're still on 2020.48. I could really use an update on the East Coast here. Get some of that California smoothness that you guys have out there. It always slows for crosswalks, even if there's nobody in them. That one, it slowed to the point it stopped in the crosswalk. They could do better with crosswalks. Like, these ones make sense. There's a stop sign next to them. All right, I'm gonna get rid of watch it again, because... So except for right here, it's typically done a good job of with this update. As I said, with creeping, it would typically creep out straight. This is more like 10 point everything earlier than 5, where it would creep out at an angle. That was very smooth. Good job. Alright, so here's the library. It's probably gonna stop us in the street. here's the library. What was that one? The other building for the library? I don't know. All right, so here we are. So now let's go back to the destination charger at the Palmer House Inn, where we just had a delicious breakfast. Ooh. No, don't do it. It would probably have been fine, but it was creeping too much into her lane, so... Alright, you got to hurry up. You're in traffic. You don't need to eat the curb. Get back on plan. So as you can see, this thing is not ready for everyday people, but if you're able to use regular autopilot for any length of time, you can handle this as long as you're paying attention. Don't be using those steering wheel hold devices. All right, so let's see what it does with this guy with the door open. Perfect timing. Whoa. All right, speed limit's not 40 here, it's 25. And of course, it still takes forever to slow down when you slow down here. But when the speed, well, here I'm pointing to the stock for you, those of you with the wheels, it would be over here. And on, when you pass a sign where the speed limit has come down, it slows down much more quickly versus the coasting out or whatever it is it does on when you tell it to adjust the speed via the wheel or, in my case, the cruise control stock. All right, so it can't even do anything with this parking lot, so we will do it. And it'll be fun because one of the longer vehicles was in the way. I guess whatever beeped at us earlier was gone, unless it was this 4Runner. So this is something I'm looking forward to with Cybertruck, with having the rear wheel steering. There are no parking spots that I reverse in, well, not none, but there are very few parking spots that I reverse into where I don't have to make it a multiple maneuver. Because of how long the car is and the way that it turns in reverse. Usually it's two motion, but sometimes I'm sloppy. Yeah, that was two motions, that's not bad. And you get your own parking space. And then the one next to it if you need it. So with that, we'll catch you on the flip side.